Grey Peelings perhaps just took it in front, last year's winner of this prize. Robert Thornton looking to make amends for that unlucky defeat from Strong Arrow in our last race. And it's Peelings, Polar Champ, Quakersfield Handy, Miss Cash on the inside jumped up well. Then Dark Romance towards the outside, followed by Galopino. And then in the inside position in a noseband is Mr. Benjamin as they climb to the high point of the course. A little bit detached early is Bless Me Sister. As they run down the hill towards the straight, and it's Peelings from Kinnis Cash and Polar Champ and Dark Romance, followed by Walking Tall and Quakersfield, and Enrico is a little bit off the track, forced to race wide. And then these are followed by Audacta towards the inside, followed through by Mr. Benjamin, who got involved in just a little bit of scrimmaging coming down the hill there. And Hadidi is out wide, away from trouble, towards the rear, the orange sleeve jacket left of frame, as they jump the first in the straight. Peelings over from Walking Tall. A mistake of that by Rudy Knight, who's the jockey with the white cap towards the rear, as they gallop on towards what'll be their last flight in a circuit's time. Enrique 6-1 in running. Oh, gone off joint favourite or co-favourite. Peelings in front from Kinnis Cash, the inner of Walking Tall. Close up is Quakersfield and then Polar Champ and Enrique. Audacta poking up the inside. Mr. Benjamin tucked away the inner. Galopino out wide. Dark Romance and Be My Mott is being scrubbed along. Then Miracle Island towards the rear. Rudy's Knight. Hannigan's Lodger. Hadidi is one from Larson. Bless Me Sister has been dropped right out by Andrew Garrity and trails by three or four lengths. Turning away from the enclosures and facing up to flights 5 and 6 down the side of the course, and it's still the Grey Peelings from Walking Tall. Kinnis Cash right on the fence, the white jacket. And then out wider, Enrique in the check colours of Robert Ogden. Polar Champ and Quakersfield right there. Galopino and Audacta. And Mr. Benjamin in the nose band. We had joint favourites on the off, Enrique and Rudy Knight, as they approach flight number 5. Peeling, Walking Tall was very untidy at that. On the outside, Enrique, who fairly bounced off this sort of surface at Sandown a week ago, travelling well. Kinnis Cash is next from Quakersfield. Miracle Island is coming under pressure. And then Mr. Benjamin back on the inside, or Dacta in the center as they jump the next. Bless Me Sister continues in last. Hadidi is being driven along out wide, and they're beginning to get well sorted out now as they approach a left-hand turn and passing their starting point. And it's Peelings from Walking Tall. Enrique, full of running on the outside. Then Kinnis Cash, the gambled on Quakersfield in fifth place. Then Mr. Benjamin moving into sixth now as they rose over the next. Peelings made a slight mistake at that and is headed by Walking Tall. Enrico on the outside. Kinnis Cash follows from Quakersfield. And then behind these is Mr. Benjamin as they jump what is their third last flight of hurdles. Hannigan's Lodger and Rudy Knight are both trying to stay on. Then Polar Champ and Audacta under pressure. So once again reaching the top of the hill, and Enrique goes into the lead pretty readily too here. Enrique in the colours of Barry Fenton. Walking Tall in second. Quakersfield is still running on in third place. May yet mount a challenge under Matty Batchelor. Peelings is next. Then Kinnis Cash, Rudy Knight, Hannigan's Lodger and Audacta as they make the downhill run for the home turn, and it's Enrique challenged by Quakersfield. Then behind these, Kinnis Cash up the far side, Peelings trying to rally, Hannigan's Lodger out wide, the market mover Mr. Benjamin dropping away now. This is the second last good jump by Enrique from Quakersfield second. They've kicked four or five away from Peelings. Audacta is staying on, then Hannigan's Lodger, Rudy's Knight, Walking Taller and Kinnis Cash, but they're all going to have to go to catch this leader. It is Enrique who's kicked right away now over the last. Enrique, Quakersfield lands second. Audacta doing his best work at the finish, but will need to fly to catch Enrique. Hannigan's Lodger back in fourth, and inside the final 100 yards, this is clearly a very progressive horse. Enrique, a 30-length winner last week, wins by at least 8 this week. In second, Audacta. In third, then, was Quakersfield, Hannigan's Lodger, Peelings and Rudy's Knight. Then Walking Tall and Galopino. Bless Me Sister followed these home from Be My Mott and Kinnis Cash and Polar Champ. Well beat was Mr. Benjamin right out the back with Dark Romance and Hadidi. And I have an idea Miracle Island was pulled up in the straight. So a highly impressive winner here, number four Enrique in the colours of Robert Ogden, trained by Philip Hobbs, who of course sent out What's Up Boys to win at the Cheltenham Festival, and ridden by Barry Fenton, who really didn't have many anxious moments on this five-year-old chestnut, always in the front three or four, pulling double and quickened away in the straight. Clearly loves good ground. In second place, number 14, Audacta, who's staying on in the hands of Barry Kenry without really being a threat. Third, then, the well-backed Quakers Field, who had every chance to out. And the fourth to finish, and they pay out on fourth in a 16-runner lineup, was number 13, Hannigan's Lodge.
Return the 6-1 joint favourite, second number 14, Audacta, 13-2. Third number 2, Quakers Field, 15-2. And fourth number 13, Hannigan's Lodge, 11-1. The other joint favourite was number 7, Rudy Knight, all 16 rounds.